Subscribe and click the bell icon for the latest updates and notifications from the Indian Express.
Xiaomi's latest new offering in the market is the Redmi 7, which has a budget price of ₹7,999 for the base variant. Now, compared to last year's Redmi 6 series, this one has quite a few changes. The design has been refreshed, it sports the new Qualcomm Snapdragon 632 processor, and it comes with a dot notch. But how does the Redmi 7 perform? Let's find out in our review. I have to say the Redmi 7's design is an improvement over last year's more boring Redmi 6. It does look more premium thanks to the glassy finish at the back, which is a plastic body, but it does look premium, especially for the price. Now, I have the black colored review unit. However, there's a red and a blue one as well with what Xiaomi is calling the Aura Smoke design, which has a darker hue at the top. Now, the advantage here is that you don't really think that this device costs less than ₹10,000 when you first hold it. Yes, this is an HD Plus resolution, but the display works fine when you're watching YouTube videos or even gaming. The color reproduction on this phone is okay, and the 6-inch plus size is in line with what most users are now expecting. So on the performance front, Redmi 7 performs admirably for this price. Running multiple apps or even keeping multiple tabs open on Chrome did not cause any problems as such. However, this is not the zippiest Redmi phone that you will find in the market. Remember, the Redmi Note 7 series is faster than this, though of course they are running better processors. Now yes, I was able to run games like say Asphalt 9 on this phone in medium settings, but at high settings that's just not possible. One should not expect that on a budget phone either. However, there is a noticeable lag when you are running games, even games like Asphalt 9, to say the more basic ones like Lara Croft Run or Alphabet. Now keep in mind, I have the 3GB RAM and 32GB variant for review. This phone does come with a dedicated microSD slot with up to 512GB support, which is again very good to see at this price point. The phone also comes with a P2I rating for splash and dust resistance, which is again something that you don't really see in this particular price point. The phone is running MIUI 10 with Android Pi. Now, Redmi 7 has a 12MP plus 2MP rear camera and an 8MP front camera. The rear camera is not bad, though I would say that in indoor lighting, it tends to smudge out some of the details. In outdoors, I thought the camera performed quite well for its price, and there were enough details in the photo and there was no trouble focusing either. However, with brighter colors like say with reds or pink, the camera tends to oversaturate them in some instances. Now there is a portrait mode as well, though it's not entirely perfect when it comes to edge detection. The selfie camera, I would say, is certainly better than average considering again the price point of this phone, but nothing great. Also, the edge detection feature does struggle in the selfie portraits as well. Now, I would say the highlight of this phone is the 4000mAh battery, because it will easily last you 2 days with moderate usage and more than a day with heavy duty usage. For a budget phone, I'd say this offers impressive battery life. So what's our verdict for the Redmi 7? The Redmi 7 is no doubt an excellent performer considering the price of this phone. The battery is the highlight out here, and it has a good performance as well. Certainly the camera performance could have been improved, but again, for its price point, the Redmi 7 is a good choice. However, if your budget is more flexible and you can afford to spend up to ₹10,000, then I would say get the Redmi Note 7, simply because that one has a full HD+ display and a better processor.